In this video, we are going to take a look at the FET configuration options and considerations for the BQ76942 and BQ76952, and we will also dive a little deeper into the cell balancing feature. The BQ76942 and 52 is a highly configurable battery monitor, and the protection is no exception. The device will monitor voltage, current, and temperature, and based on the configuration, it will qualify a protection event. Once that event is determined, there is an individual mask that can be set to control the discharge, charge, alert, and fuse outputs independently. The charge and discharge outputs for FET control are recoverable FETs. The alert pin is an interrupt or signal to the MCU, and the fuse output is used to permanently disable the pack. The FET drivers are high side. In-channel FETs are supported for charge and discharge, with the battery on the left side. Normally, we would expect the current would go through a fuse to the charge FET and the discharge FET and off to the pack plus. There is an integrated charge pump on the CP1 pin that provides the power for the high side FET drivers. There are two levels that can be selected, 5 volts and 11 volts. Also supported are pre-charge and pre-discharge. Both are P-channel drivers. These pins are pulled down when enabled, and they are high impedance when they are off. The charge driver is a resistive driver. It works on a charge transfer principle from the charge pump, so the charge is stored in the CP1 capacitor, after switching is distributed between that capacitor and the capacitance of the FET gate. The charge pump does run, but it is a low current output. The switching time on the charge FET is in the tens of microseconds. At turnoff, the driver switches to the BAT voltage. Again, it is a resistive turnoff. A resistor should be placed between the charge pin and the gate. So the charge pin will switch first, and the gate will follow, with the RC time constant between the resistor and the gate capacitance. For the discharge driver, again at turn on, it switches to the charge pump voltage. Discharge is also resistive, with a resistor to the gate capacitance. So discharge will rise quickly, and the gate voltage will rise somewhat more slowly. Again, switching time will be in the tens of microseconds. At turnoff for the discharge output, the driver is pulled quickly to a level below the low detect pin. The LD pin senses the pack voltage, so this attempts to turn off the FET quickly, and then relaxes and repeats. This allows the gate to discharge slowly as needed, and the switching only runs for a limited time. With the switching action and the gate capacitance, the gate will discharge more slowly to where the FET is off. A smaller resistor will give faster turnoff and can drop very quickly, or it can support more FETs with more reasonable turnoff. And of course, pack plus still has the discharge from the battery voltage to a low value. The IC itself does not discharge the pack pin. The device has a body diode protection feature that is enabled with the default configuration. In a series FET configuration, if the charge FET is turned on and the pack is discharging, there is a diode in the charge FET. And with a large current, this could heat the FET significantly. So the part will detect that current and turn the charge FET back on so that the FET is not damaged from the large discharge current. When parallel FETs are used, that switching is undesired because if there is a discharge current that does not go through the charge FET, and if the charge FET is off, it may be bad to have that turned back on. So this feature is configurable, and parallel FET mode basically turns off the body diode protection. FET driver control normally comes through the enabled protections or through host commands through communication into a control block. Signals are derived to run on the discharge and charge drivers, which are powered from the charge pump. Also available are direct CFET off and DFET off inputs to turn off the FETs. However, these need to be configured for that purpose. Additionally, there are digital discharge and digital charge outputs. Those can be used for logic level signaling to an MCU or to run a low side driver if the high side driver is not used. The digital discharge and digital charge pins are multifunction pins and they must be configured as outputs. For the multifunction pins, there is quite a bit of flexibility. Typically, these can be used for temperature measurement or for a direct ADC input or a general purpose digital output. So it is important for the system designer to set the configuration properly. For a low side FET drive, the D discharge and D charge signals can be brought out. They are typically powered on Reg 1. The regulator voltage is programmable and needs to be configured. Those signals can be brought to a FET driver. For discharge, that will easily drive one or more low side discharge FETs. Although similar for the charge driver, there are some differences here. When the charge FET is off, The source of the FET may go to a low negative voltage because the charger voltage could be much bigger than the battery voltage. So a P-channel FET is needed at the output of the driver so that the gate can fall. Also, when the discharge FETs are off and a load is present on the pack, pack minus may be pulled to a high voltage. So the voltage back through the gate circuitry needs to be blocked so it doesn't get into the driver. Because of the diode, the driver cannot directly turn off the gates. That would be done by the gate resistance, the RGS pull-down. Since that would be a large resistance due to the desire to have low current, it may be beneficial to have an assistance circuit in a transistor to provide some gain and pull down the gate. Another thing that would be needed for a low-side driver is a power supply for that driver. Most FETs are specified with a low RDS on at 10 volts, so a 12-volt supply is appropriate. Now let's take a look at cell balancing with the BQ76942 and BQ76952 family. Cell balancing can be configured to be autonomous or controlled by the host. There are a number of registers to configure the operation, as shown in this image capture from the BQ Studio software. Host control balancing is available in sealed mode. Balancing can be blocked by high or low temperature. It does time out each cell balance interval, so if the host comes in and sets up the cell balancing and then goes to sleep, the cells will not be drained by the device. Balancing of multiple cells is allowed. When balancing multiple cells, make sure to calculate the power dissipation when determining the balance current and number of cells to balance. For example, 65 milliamps into 25 ohms is a tenth of a watt, and this will raise the temperature of the device. For the normal balancing loop flow, the internal balance FET is turned on. Current will be drawn from the cell through the internal balance FET and returned to the cell. If there is a charge current flowing, some of the charge current will be diverted around the cell that's being balanced. The cell input resistance is typically 20 ohms, and values up to 100 ohms can be used. The typical RDS on is 25 ohms for the internal balance FET. This results in a balance current of around 65 milliamps at a cell voltage of 4.2 volts. The balance current is switched off for cell voltage measurements, so the average current is slightly lower. External balancing can be done with an N-channel FET. Again, current flows through the input filter resistors into the internal balance FET, back out of the lower resistor. In this case, the voltage across the lower resistor develops the gate source voltage available to the FET. It is important to provide a resistance there and a diode for a high cell count pack. The reason being, imagine this might be a cell 10 sitting at 40 volts. The pack might be short-circuited and this voltage suddenly becomes approximately zero. That would put 40 volts across this resistor. If that was delivered to the gate of this FET, it could potentially be damaged. Many FETs have a 20 volt absolute maximum VGS or lower. With the divider, around 1/3 of the voltage is available for the gate source voltage. So for external balancing, this resistance can be increased to 100 ohms. It is not recommended to go beyond 100 ohms. 100 ohms with the typical input resistance is about 1.8 volts for the gate source voltage. P-channel balancing can also be used. In this case, current would flow similarly, but the voltage is now developed across the upper resistor for the cell. And with low cell voltages, it can be attractive to use a BJT for cell balancing. Either an NPN or PNP can be used. Here, the protection zener and a diode, since there is a diode in the base emitter voltage, will provide a path to reduce this resistance as it flows through the internal balance FET. Some of the current will go out through the input resistor, some will flow through the base resistor to provide a base emitter current, which will be gained up for the balance current. Resistances are small, so the balance current may be limited by the gain of the transistor. In summary, the BQ76942 and 52 family controls high-side FETs by default. The charge pump is current limited, so that should be kept in mind. The device can support multiple FETs for high current applications. It can be configured for either serial or parallel FETs. The FET configuration is flexible. The FETs can be controlled manually or autonomously. Many protections can be configured to control the FETs or send an interrupt to the host. The D-charge and D-discharge pins can be configured to drive a low-side FET driver. For cell balancing, the device supports high internal balance current. External FETs or BJTs can be used to increase the balance current if needed. Thanks for watching. Look out for more information for the BQ76942 and BQ76952 in the product folders linked below. Be sure to click the Subscribe to Updates button in the product folder to be notified as new helpful materials become available.